Welcome back to Daily Flash. I'm Mitch English. It is time for us to check in with Tony Toscano to find out what's coming out of Hollywood and straight to your screen, no matter what size you're going to watch it on. With the latest,
here's Tony.
Thanks, Mitch. Streaming on Netflix is the animated fantasy adventure, Nimona.
Your sidekick has arrived.
I don't need a sidekick.
Every villain needs a sidekick.
I'm not a villain. The real villain is still out there, and I do need help.
And then, who do you want to kill first?
What?
Look, I can help you, but promise me you won't freak out.
Why would I trust you?
Promise!
I promise!
Even when you see the horn?
Horn!
Promise!
I promise, I will not freak!
This is the part where you run.
When a knight is framed for a crime he didn't commit, the only one who can help him prove his innocence is Nimona, a mischievous teen with a taste for mayhem who also happens to be a shape-shifting creature he has been trained to destroy. I chatted with the film star, Chloe Grace Moritz.
What a beautiful character Nimona is. It must have been a joy to play her.
It was a joy to play her. You know, she has such high highs and low lows and so much dimension. I mean, it felt like, you know, it took as much mental dexterity as it would, you know, being on screen, and even more so. You know, we really wanted to capture the chaos of her. And then when, you know, you find those quiet moments with her, that juxtaposition needs to feel so great and so raw and vulnerable, which was difficult and like a puzzle to try to, you know, put together every day. But it was just so fun to do over a few years.
Nimona is a fun, fast-paced, and wonderfully animated action fantasy with a lot of heart and humor. Check it out on Netflix. It gets an A and is rated PG. Hitting theaters, Harrison Ford is back for a fifth time in Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny.
Dad told me you found something on a train during the war. A dial that could change the course of history.
Why are you chasing the thing that drove your father crazy?
Don't move.
We need to get out of here.
Stop!
Sorry.
Helena!
Dr. Jones, get him.
In the film, Indiana Jones is approaching retirement and is trying to fit into a world that has outgrown him. But an old rival from the past returns, and Indy must don his hat and pick up his whip once more to save the world. Our cameras caught up to Harrison Ford at the world premiere.
Well, I'm celebrating this film and this installment, but I'm also celebrating all of those people who have kept us making these movies for 42 years and whom I owe everything. And I really hope that they like our movie.
I'll start off by saying Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny is a very watchable action adventure. Harrison Ford does a terrific job, and the film's pacing is great. The downside is in the script, which has plot holes big enough to drive trucks through. And on a massively anticipated film like this one is, that kind of shabby writing is not acceptable. Again, Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny is in selected theaters now. It gets a C and is rated PG-13. For the Daily Flash, I'm film critic Tony Toscano.